Yes. Now we did sovereign, right? Socialist. Now before this term socialist was added by the 42nd Amendment in 1976. Officially known as the Constitution Act 1976 was enacted during the emergency by the Indian National Congress government headed by respected late Mrs. Indira Gandhi. The Constitution had socialist content in the form of certain directive principles of state policy. The term socialist used here refers to democratic socialism. It is a philosophy of supporting political democracy within a socially owned economy with a particular emphasis on economic democracy, workplace democracy, and workers' self-management with a market socialist economy or some form of decentralization. That is, achievement of socialist goals through democratic, even evolutionary socialist goals through democratic, evolutionary, and non-violent means. By non-violent means. However, it means that since wealth is generated socially, wealth should be shared equally by the society through distributive justice, not concentrated in the hands of few. And the government should regulate the ownership of land and industry to reduce socio-economic inequalities. And you will read about socialism in Europe in the next class when you go to class 9, socialism in Europe and the Russian Revolution. You will come to know what is this socialism all about. It cannot go, the whole thing cannot go into someone's hand, the wealth. It has to be equally divided in the society according to their star rated or according to the system or according to the chart. That is socialist. Okay. Achievement of socialist goals. What is socialism? We have to know that first. Socialist or socialism means, I'm thinking and I'm reading my notes as well in front of me, so I'm just trying to think what is the easiest way to explain it to you. It means making, moving and trading wealth should be owned or controlled by the workers. People who agree this type of system are called socialists. Understood. Now, if we say what is a socialism government, it means planning, producing, and distributing goods is controlled by a central government. That's our Delhi or the top people who are sitting there that theoretically seek more just an equitable distribution of property and labor. But most what has happened in the past is socialist governments have ended up being no more than dictatorships. They take a wrong U-turn. India, it's also happening. But we'll not go to that part. You can say worker self-management. Socialism. Okay. Now we come to secular. What does secular mean? Secular means that the relationship between the government and the religious groups are determined according to the constitution and law. In Hindi, it's generally known in the constitution as Panthni. I'm forgetting the name. It's very, I can't pronounce it in Hindi. I'm very bad at Hindi. It's Panthni Rap Ke Sata. Panthni Rap Ke Sata. Panthni Rap Ke Sata. और पंथनी रपेक्षता, पंथनी रपेक्षता, इट सेपरेट्स द पावर ऑफ द स्टेट एंड रिलीजन. देर इज नो डिफरेंस ऑफ रिलीजन. हिंदुइज्म, बुद्धिज्म, जैनिज्म, सिखिज्म, क्रिश्चियनिटी एंड इस्लाम आर इक्वली रिस्पेक्टेड एंड मोर ओवर देर इज नो स्टेट रिलीजन. ऑल द सिटीजन्स ऑफ इंडिया आर अलाउड टू प्रोफेस, प्रैक्टिस एंड प्रोपोगेट देर ओन religion. Explaining the meaning of secularism as adopted by India, means is a part of the basic structure of the Indian constitution. And it means equal freedom and respect for all religions. That is secular. There is no state religion. A state religion is a religious body or creed officially endorsed by a state. A state has an official religion. Okay. Some parts of Africa have it, some other parts are there which have it. We don't want to go into that. We'll just be in India. Democratic. They elect their own governments, you know that. By a system of universal adult franchise. Popularly known as one person, one vote. Every citizen of India has to be 18 years of age or older and not otherwise debarred by law is entitled to vote. The word democratic, democracia, or democrata, the word democratic refers to not only to political democracy but also to social and economic democracy. Democracy. Republic is the head of the state is elected and not a hereditary monarch. Where no one holds public power as property, proprietary right. As opposed to a monarchy in which the head of a state is appointed on a hereditary basis. Until abdication. But in republic, is an entity in which people, which the head of the state is elected directly or indirectly for a fixed tenure. Not tenure, it's actually tenure. Thus, India has a president who is elected and has a fixed term of the office. There is an absence of any privileged class, hence all public offices being open to every citizen without discrimination. That is republic. Got my point? So now we can come to the book. It says constitution, importance of our constitution, need for laws, dowry, female feudicide. Now it says importance of our constitution. Next video.